Hello, boys and girls. This is Hana Harmony. I have a great and wonderful story called A Wise Choice. Memory verse. Today's memory verse from Genesis chapter 41, 16. I cannot do it, but God will. The message for today is God can help us do anything. Have you ever been asked to do something that was really hard? Joseph was asked to tell Pharaoh about some dreams, but he couldn't do it alone. The morning light poured through the palace windows. Pharaoh woke up. His head headache. His head headached. He had not slept well at all. He had very strange dreams. Bring the wise men to me, he called to his servants. The wise men listened carefully as the king told them about his strange dreams. They whispered together and shook their heads. We don't know what the dreams mean, they admitted. Suddenly, Pharaoh's cupbearer stepped forward. When I was in prison 2 years ago, the cupbearer began, I had a strange dream too. A young man named Joseph told me what my dream meant, and everything happened exactly as he said it would. Pharaoh pointed toward the door. Bring this Joseph to me. The guards rushed to the jail and brought Joseph out. He shaved and put on clean clothes. Then the guards hurried him to the king. I had a dream, Pharaoh told Joseph. No one here can tell me what it means. I hear that you can explain dreams. Tell me what my dream means. Joseph answered truthfully, I cannot explain the meaning of dreams, but God will tell me, and I will tell you. I dreamed I was standing on a river bank. Pharaoh began, I saw seven beautiful fat cows come out of the river and begin to eat grass. Then seven skinny cows came out, and then seven skinny cows ate up the seven fat cows. And then I had another dream. Pharaoh continued, I saw seven plump heads of grain growing out of a stalk. Then seven more thin, ugly heads of grain grew out of the same stalk. And the thin heads of grain swallowed off the plump, full heads. Both the dreams mean the same thing. Joseph began, God is telling you what he is going to do. There will be 7 good years for growing food, and then there will be 7 years of hunger because food will not grow. You need to choose a man who is wise. Joseph said, let him store the extra food that grows in the 7 good years. So there will be food during the 7 years of famine, and the people will not die of hunger. Pharaoh was pleased to hear Joseph's ideas. He took his own ring off his finger and put it on Joseph. He put a gold chain around Joseph's neck. You are in charge of all the land of Egypt, Pharaoh proclaimed. You are second in command under me. So Joseph began his new work. He rode around the land and arranged to store all the extra food that grew in the 7 good years. Joseph was not in jail anymore. He was working for the king. But Joseph knew one thing was the same. God would take care of him in the palace, just as he had in the jail. So he take care of us in our daily time. See you, boys and girls. Oh. A wise choice, the getting ready to teach the Bible lesson at a glance. Pharaoh has a dream. He knows it is important, but he doesn't understand what it means. His wise man can't explain the dream either. Then his cupbearer remembers that Joseph knows about dreams. Pharaoh sends for Joseph. God tells Joseph what the dream means, and Joseph gives God the credit. Pharaoh is so pleased with Joseph that he lets him out of jail and puts him in charge of everything in Egypt. God blesses Joseph because he is willing to be used to do God's will. This is a lesson about grace. We don't know what God has planned for our lives, but if we are willing to be led by God, He can help us do anything. It can help us do anything. So, the teacher enrichment. From the dungeon, Joseph was exhorted to be ruler over all the land of Egypt. It was a position of high honor, yet it was beset with difficulty and peril. But Joseph's character bore the test of life of adversity and prosperity. The same fidelity to God was manifest when he stood in the palace of the Pharaoh as when in a prisoner's cell. He was still a stranger in a hidden land, separated from his kindred, the worshippers of God, but he fully believed that the divine hand had directed his steps, and in constant reliance upon God, he faithfully discharged the duties of his position. Through Joseph, the attention of the king and great men of Egypt was directed to the true God, and though they adhered to their idolatry, they learned to respect the principles revealed in the life and character of the worshiper of Jehovah. Do we like Joseph, trusting God to work in our lives according to His will? Are we attentive to follow God's leading and give Him complete control? Room decoration. We need room decoration too. Readiness activities. Selectively, actively, most appropriate for your situation. A God does teach the children the following finger play, go through it a few times. Who makes the sun shine? Put arms out and move in big circle. And God does raise arms in the air, wiggle fingers and hands. Who makes the rain fall? Raise arms and lower them while wiggling fingers like rain falling. God does. Raise arms in the air, wiggle fingers and hands. God does. Who makes the grass grow? Put hands on ground, wiggle fingers while bringing them. And God does. Raise arms in the air, wiggle fingers and hands. And God does. Who makes the wind blow? Move arms back and forth like wind blowing. God does. Raise arms in the air, wiggle fingers and hands. alternative ask the question, as the children act them out, and let them respond with the answer, God does. Debriefing. Allow response time as you ask, can you make the sunshine or the rain fall or the grass grow or the wind blow? No, God does. Some things are impossible for us to do, and sometimes there are things that we are asked to do that seems very hard. When things seem very hard, God can help us. Our Bible story is about Joseph doing some very hard things. Today's message is God can help us. Help us do something. Say that with me. Be mission possible. Practice this in advance. Fold on 8.5 times 11. A4 paper, piece of paper in half length side from the folded side. Make 9 partial cuts that partial cuts that come within an inch of the edge of the paper. Flip over the paper and make 8 similar cuts without cutting each end piece. Cut along the fold of the inner pieces to make a paper loop that is large enough to step through. Allow response time as you ask, who thinks I can step through this piece of paper? Don't you think I could fit? Could you fit? Cut a large hole in the middle of one piece of paper and try to fit it over a child, but don't make it work. It seems it's impossible, but watch this. Cut another paper, same size as you practiced, and step through it. Allow the children at one a time to step through your paper too. Debriefing, allow response time as you ask. If it sounded impossible when I said I was going to step through that piece of paper, didn't it? Sometimes there are things that we are asked to do that seem very hard. We just don't think that we can do them. You didn't think you could fit through that small piece of paper, but all of you did it. When things seem very hard, God can help us. Our Bible story is about Joseph doing some very hard things that God wanted him to do and helped him to do. Today's message is God can help us do anything. Note prayer and praise appears. Bible lesson. Experiencing the story, have a pillow and a blanket or towel for each child. Say, every time I say the word dream, put both of you hands together and hold them to the side of your head as if you are sleeping. Come and sit in the jail and pretend to be with Joseph in jail as we listen to the story. Read or tell the story. One night Joseph was sleeping nicely. Can we all lie down and pretend to sleep? Suddenly there were the sounds of footsteps. Some of Pharaoh's servants, Pharaoh was the king, came right to Joseph's bed. They said, Joseph, get up. Pharaoh wants to see you right away. He had some dreams. Pharaoh wants to see you right away. He had some dreams in the night and nobody can tell him what they mean. Pharaoh's cupbearer said that you can tell the meaning of dreams. What do you think happened next? The guards quickly brought him, Joseph, out of the prison. He shaved, put on clean clothes and went before the king. Have the class leave the jail and go to jail. There sits Let's pretend to get cleaned up like Joseph did, wash our hair and face, put on nice clean clothes, move to the throne room scene. Peru said, they tell me, you can tell me what my dream means. Is this true? Joseph shook his head. No, he said, I can't do that, but God can. God knows the meaning of your dreams. Peru told Joseph about these dreams. In the first dream, Peru was standing out a river bank, and out of the river, came seven big and healthy looking cows. Let's pretend our left hand is a big healthy cow walking along. Then seven ugly, skinny, sick looking cows came out of the river. Let's pretend this hand, right hand, is a skinny, sick looking cow. Can you guess what happened next? The skinny cows gobbled up the fat cows. Heavy right skinny cow hand gobbled up your left fat cow hand. Let the children do it too. But you know what? The skinny cow was still skinny and sick looking. Peru had another dream too. In this one, there was a stalk of grain with seven beautiful, fat, and healthy-looking heads of grain. Use your hands as before to act this part out. Hold your fingers straight up for the healthy grain. Then there were seven tiny, fluffy heads of grain. Use other hand with fingers drooping. Can you guess what happened? The tiny fluffy heads of grain are the healthy straight ones. Peru said to Joseph, I asked my wise men to tell me what my dreams mean, but they couldn't help me. They didn't know. Do you know? Joseph told Peru, God is giving you a message. He sent you the dreams to tell you what he's going to do. Your dreams both mean the same thing. The seven fat, healthy-looking cows and the seven fat, healthy-looking cows and the seven fat, healthy-looking grains mean that you will have seven good years of everything growing big. There will be lots of rain and lots of food to eat. The seven skinny cows and the seven thin fluffy heads of grain mean that you will have seven bad years after the good years. There will be very little rain, and the things in your fields won't grow very well. It will be a time of famine. People will be hungry. The people won't remember all the good years. God is telling you this so that you can be prepared. Joseph told Peru that he should put someone in charge to save food during the seven good years, so the people would have food to eat during the seven bad years. Peru thought that was a very good idea, and he asked Joseph to do the job. Peru put Joseph in charge of the whole land of Egypt. He gave Joseph a special ring and beautiful clothes. Peru put a gold chain around Joseph's neck. That means he was in charge. So it was that Joseph went throughout the land helping the people save food. So this story will be going on. Debriefing, allow response time as you ask. How do you think Joseph felt when he was called to see Peru? Did Peru know what his dreams meant? These Peru's wise men know what the dreams meant. Who told Joseph what Peru's dreams meant? What did they mean? What work What work did Pharaoh give to Joseph? Did the king make a wise choice? How do you think Joseph felt? Would it be a big job for Joseph to do? Who would help him? God helps you too. When you have big things to do that seem very helping you and loving you. Remember our message? God can help us do anything. Say that with me. Bible study. Open your Bible to Genesis chapter 41. Point to the text and say, this is where today's story is found in God's Word. The Bible read selected verses aloud, preparing as necessary, debriefing, allow response time as you ask, do you think Joseph thought the cupbearer and the forgotten all about him in jail? Who hadn't forgotten about Joseph? God never forgets about you either. Who helped Joseph tell Pharaoh the meaning of his dreams? Who helped Joseph with his new job? God will help you too. When you have things to do that seem hard, remember, God can help us do anything. Say that with me. Yeah, memory verse. Turn to Genesis chapter 41, 16 and say, this is where we find our memory verse in God's Word, the Bible. Read the verse aloud, I cannot do it, but God will. Then proceed to teach the memory verse as outlined below. I pointed to self, cannot do it, back and forth, no, but God will. Point upward, then no head, yes. Nod head, yes. Genesis chapter 41, 16, palm together, then open. So see, practice, or just listen. This is really so good idea, good lesson. Thank you, see you guys. Applying the lesson, but God can. Have the children spread out, say, let's see what we can do. Do what I say, if you can. If not, let's say together. No, but God can. Do the actions together as you say. Can you hope three times? Smile and giggle, make the sunshine? No, but God can. Can you touch your toes? Say thank you. Make the rain fall? No, but God can. Can you turn around? Clap your hands? Make the green grow? No, but God can. Can you touch your ears? Bend side always? Make the wind blow? No, but God can. Deep breathing. Allow response time as you ask, what are some things that you really like to do? Why? You can do many things. But there are some things that you can't do. What are some things that you still need help with? Tying shoes, riding a bike, reaching a high self, make a bed, etc. Moms and dads can't do some things either, but God can. What are some things that only God can do? Sometimes God asks you to do things that seem hard, like obeying quickly and with a smile, or sharing your toys with your friend or letting your neighbor go first in the game you are playing. Can you think of any other things that you have a hard time doing? God will always be with you, helping you to do hard things. It's good to remember God can help us do anything. Sharing the lesson, the Joseph's chain, an advanced copy, the chain pattern onto yellow, orange, or gold paper. On page for each child, cut the chain pattern along the dotted lines to make 16 stripes of paper. Two will be blank to separate the memory verse from the message. Say, you are going to make a chain out of paper. We will help you put the paper stripes in order. And then start a chain by looping the first memory verse wood stripe and then stapling or tapping it. Then take the next word of your memory verse and loop the stripe word side out through the first one and stapple or tape it. Put in a blank loop after the memory verse. Put another blank loop after the last word of the message and stapple or tape them to make a complete chain. Debriefing. The chain that you made can remind you of the gold chain that Pharaoh gave to Joseph when he put him in charge of all of Egypt. Take it home and share it with someone as you tell them how God helped Joseph and when he had big and small jobs to do. He will help you too. If you just ask him, let's say our message together, one test time. God can help us do anything. Closing, have a child pray. Wish everyone a good week and remind them to share the story with their family. Prayer and praise, fellowship. Report the students' joys and sorrows, pleased and troubled, as reported to you at the door as appropriate. Allow time for sharing experiences from last week's lesson, study and review the memory verse, acknowledge any birthdays, special events, or achievements. Give a special warm greeting to our visions, suggested songs. He's able, Jesus never fails, my God is so great, wonder song, Jesus loves me, mission, use a story from children's mission, offering, say, God can help us do anything. One thing we can do is share our offerings with others, prayer, pair children with others. Give each pair a picture or an object of something for which to thank God, animals, family, food, bed, sunshine, etc. Let them thank God for the thing in their picture. Thank you for all your listening.
Hello, boys and girls. This is Hannah Moni. I have a great, wonderful story called A Wise Choice. Today's memory verse from Genesis chapter 41:16. I cannot do it, but God will. The message for today is God can help us do anything. Have you ever been asked to do something that was really hard? Joseph was asked to tell Pharaoh about some dreams, but he couldn't do it alone. The morning light poured through the palace windows. Pharaoh woke up. His head ached. He had not slept well at all. He had very, very strange dreams. Bring the wise man to me, he called to his servants. The wise men listened carefully as the king told them about his strange dreams. They whispered together and shook their heads. We don't know what the dreams mean, they admitted. Suddenly, Pharaoh's cupbearer stepped forward. When I was in prison 2 years ago, the cupbearer began. I had a strange dream too. A young man a young man named Joseph told me what my dream meant, and everything happened exactly as he said it would. Pharaoh pointed toward the door, "Bring this Joseph to me." The guards rushed to the jail and brought Joseph out. He shaved and put on clean clothes. Then the guards hurried him to the king. "I had a dream," Pharaoh told Joseph. "No one here can tell me what it means. I hear that you can explain dreams. Tell me what my dream means." Joseph answered truthfully, "I cannot explain the meaning of dreams, but God will tell. But God will tell me, then I will tell you. I dreamed I was standing on a river bank," Pharaoh began. "I saw seven beautiful fat cows come out of the river and began to eat grass. Then seven skinny cows came out, and the seven skinny cows ate off the seven fat cows. And then I had another dream," Pharaoh continued. "I saw seven plump heads of grain growing out of a stalk. Then seven more thin, ugly of a stalk. Then seven more thin, ugly heads of grain grew out of the same stalk. And the thin heads of grain swallowed up the plump, full heads." "Both the dreams mean the same thing," Joseph began. "God is telling you what he is going to do. There will be seven good years for growing food, and then there will be 7 years of hunger because food will not grow. You need to choose a man who is wise," Joseph said. "Let him store the extra food that grows in the 7 good years, so there will be food during the 7 years of famine, and the people will not die of hunger." Pharaoh was pleased to hear Joseph's ideas. He took his own ring off his finger and put it on Joseph. He put a gold chain around Joseph's neck. "You are in charge of all the land of Egypt," Pharaoh proclaimed. You are second in command under me." So Joseph began his new work. He rode around the land and arranged to store all the extra food that grew in the 7 good years. Joseph was not in jail anymore. He was working for the king. But Joseph knew one thing was the same. God would take care of him in the palace, just as he had in the jail. So, boys and girls, God always take care of us. We cannot do ourselves, but God will. God can help us do anything. See you then next lesson.